It's Tuesday. Heights. So I just watched Maureen Johnson very courageously do a trapeze thing. She swung back and forth and she was up really high and there was a net underneath her and all of that good stuff. And I commend her for doing that because I wouldn't have even been able to climb up the thing to get there. My sixth grade class went to this camp place and we did a zip wire. And we had to climb up a ladder. Like, it wasn't even really a ladder. It was pretty much just rungs stuck into a tree. And it was this really tall tree. And we had to climb up in a line. Like, I had somebody I was supposed to be following up a tree. And everyone else was doing the zip wire and having a grand old time. I couldn't even get up the tree. I was stuck at the bottom of the tree, shaking, crying. It was the most horrible thing I had ever done. And I think it took me, like, an hour to even get up the tree. And the teachers were helping me. And I remember my sixth grade teacher, Miss Cronin, was trying to hold my hand and she was saying it was going to be okay, and I was just sobbing that I don't even really remember the actual zip wire thing because I think I was crying so much and was just so relieved that I had gotten over climbing the tree that, I mean, I didn't look down because we were going over like a ravine or something, but it was probably one of the scariest, most horrible experiences of my life. And it also reminds me of the time, around the same time, I was babysitting my friends, Clarice and Molly. We were doing something that involved being at the top of their bunk bed. They had one of those, like, little kid bunk beds that aren't even that tall. I mean, I'm not that tall, but it was not much taller than me. I've been this height for a long time. But we were on the top bunk playing with Beanie Babies or something because they wanted to do that. And it took them a long time to even get me to climb the bunk bed to get up there in the first place. But when they were done playing, they got down, and I couldn't. I was just, like, holding the bars on the side and looking down, and I was so petrified that I didn't even move. And I had to wait until their parents came back later in the evening, and then her dad had to help me down. And it was embarrassing, and that's why I will never be on the top bunk ever, ever, ever again. Another scary story of me climbing things that I didn't want to climb was when I was 9 years old. It was the first time I went to New York. I was either 9 or 8. And my dad had the brilliant idea that we should climb the Statue of Liberty. And my mom and my sister only went to the halfway point that the elevator takes you to. But my dad insisted on taking me all the way up to her hat. And if you go all the way up to her hat, eventually, the stairs become a spiral staircase going up a really thin, it looks like the inside is all penny stuff, but it's a spiral staircase and it's very small, like each step is really close to the last one, and everybody was really tight together because there were a lot of people who were climbing up there because they're all crazy. But I just remember, we have a picture somewhere, I got to the top and I was bawling my eyes out, and I looked like I did not want to be there because we had to go down, and I was freaking out because we're going to have to go down the spiral staircase too. It was horrible, but I'm crying in the picture, and my dad is just pretty much like, and yeah, so I don't recommend the Statue of Liberty if you're afraid of heights, spiral staircases, crowds, small spaces. Yeah, it's pretty much a scared person's nightmare. But that doesn't mean I can't appreciate her on the outside. After all this height stuff, NaNoWriMo update. I have 26,762 words at this point. Here's the last part that I wrote. The teacher tisked and shook her head. The mayor forbids it, especially in her case, because the zombie race has a weakness that is stronger than yours or mine. When surrounded by humans, not unlike yourself, she might forget herself and try to eat someone. Claire scowled at the teacher. I would not! I know you would not, and Mark, I'm sure, knows you would not, but the mayor worries about such things, because he does not know any better. He only knows what the media tells him. Zombies eat people in movies, so he is afraid of widespread death and panic should you or your parents leave the community. That is why he provides cadavers, so your family is happy and fed. Mark blinked and looked at Claire, confused. Cadavers? It's kind of funny that the girl who's so terrified of heights is not afraid of zombies in the slightest. And until Thursday, this is Tuesday, Don't climb anything crazy.